Calm the fuck down.
Calm the fuck down.
With David and Aaron.
With David and Aaron.
Flash! A dangerous winter storm is coming, Aaron.
It is coming.
Oh, man.
It's my mother. No, I'm just kidding. She is actually on her way here, but she's not the storm.
Let's hope she's... Do you fucking believe... Do you know that those planes were new? They were new. You know what I'm talking about?
Not a fucking clue.
The Boeing 737-95s.
Okay.
The one Alaska Airlines where it blew out the door.
Okay.
They were brand new planes.
Well, somebody didn't fucking tighten the screw.
Tighten the screw? They were brand new. And they recall...
Well, because people don't take pride in their work anymore. And these companies just want stuff out there so they can make money. And they skip... Do you know I just watched the 3 Mile Island?
Oh, my God. I lived
very
it.
Very similar.
I lived it. Erie, PA. See? We were right by 3 Mile Island.
And the guy was saying that these people put up these nuclear power plants.
Yep.
And they didn't do... They want to make money.
Quick. Fast.
Yes.
And they skip
$1 billion
on the safety.
Budgets and they skip on the safety.
Yep. I got something... I heard your phone
you
just
did
now.
You did nothing of the sort.
I did
I'm
so.
Turning it off right now.
No, the business of those planes and your mother is up in the plane.
She is,
a kid, thank God there is no God. But thank the universe that there was no one sitting by the window.
Yeah.
A teenage boy's t-shirt was sucked off of him. Ripped off of him.
Must have scared the shit out of that kid. He won't be flying anymore.
Oh my God. Can you imagine the lawsuits that are going to be coming now?
Yeah.
Everything is litigious. Everything is fucking
and
litigious.
It's so expensive. I'm trying to get a flight out to see my daughter next month, right?
Yeah.
It's a baby shower.
Yeah.
$1,000 for one round trip ticket.
Why? $1,000?
Yeah.
I could go to England on $1,000.
Not anymore. You probably need $5,000.
Well,
to England.
I fly first class, but I would take my luggage for $1,000.
I think it's a shame that people can't go and do things because of those kinds of prices.
Nope. Not anymore.
Right.
Not anymore.
And there's no need for a ticket to be $1,000. You're gonna fly that fucking plane there no matter what, right? What you know, you'd probably fill more planes if you charged $100 for a ticket. And people can't afford to see their families, and it's
I'm sorry, what?
No. Are you doing?
Mm-hmm. I was just...
Okay.
No.
Mock my misery.
Ladies and Jen?
Ladies and that one girl, Jen, back
Jen
there?
Jen back there. Aaron Galbraith's new single, Mock My Tragedy.
Girl, I will write a song
Mock My Tragedy. Have a smoke. That's what you need.
Maybe I do need a smoke.
You need a smoke. You need to lighten up, bitch.
Well, last week we did not record because I was sick. Why was Aaron sick? Let's talk about that.
I was in the midst of the chemo dragon.
Mm-hmm.
And so it just so happened. I'm the one feeling bad that it's me being chemoed out. I couldn't move. This cumulative chemo is... Well, we know. But I truly believe that the tumor's gone.
I truly believe
as I take breaths of your smoke into my lungs.
It's what's helping you.
Yeah, it is. But you have a story that is just mind fucking
deplorable.
Numb. Mind numbing.
So
a needle pulling thread.
One Saturday a month there is a pool league game. You play for money.
Billiards.
Yeah. Like, I mean, maybe you win $100. I don't really know. Whatever it is. Anyway, I didn't win.
Yeah.
So, second time, 2 months in a row, my husband says, let's go. I want to be there.
It's on a Saturday, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's fun.
Go to the local bar. I'm not going to name the bar, nor am I going to mention the actual name of this woman, just because.
Greta at Cheers.
Greta from Cheers shows up. She runs the league. And she's...
This defies description.
Now, right away, I don't get sick a lot because, like you, I wear my mask. I stay home.
Yes.
And I don't participate social events.
Yes. Antisocial.
And antisocial has saved my life. And I have had COVID. I am vaccinated. It's not about that. I'm not. And, you know, everybody has a right to their own opinions and views. Right. So anyway, my only view is I think if you don't feel good, stay the fuck home.
Thank you.
So she's.
How old is this Greta?
I would say in her 50s.
Motherfucking
right? And this
bitch.
Is right after.
What a bitch.
This is right after Christmas. She says, I'm sorry I'm sick. Everybody was sick over the holidays. Now I'm sick. But if I don't show up to run the pool league, nobody's going to be able to play. So if everybody gets sick, too fucking bad.
She said that. So if everybody gets sick, too fucking bad.
I'm too fucking bad right here. Sick. My mother-in-law got sick. My husband got sick. Okay. My son, who just stays 3 floors above me and, you know, only comes for gas and food money. So he was fine. Venmo saved his life.
Yes.
But like a whole week and
You had a fever.
I did. Well, what happened was last Tuesday I had my colonoscopy. I woke up in the morning at 4 a.m. and I was throwing up. But on the prep, it says nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and a headache is common. I'm like, oh, and I have a headache.
Yeah.
I go to the place. Everything was normal. Everything was fine. My blood pressure, they take your temp.
They did a fire hose up her ass.
They did. They didn't even put me out.
No, they brought the local fire league.
Yeah.
There.
I couldn't afford anesthesia.
No. And it was, they usually do twilight sleep.
Yeah, no, no.
But what they did was tinkle sleep for you.
This was a tinkle sleep.
Tinkle sweet. And they stuck the hose up her ass and just said, go, Charlie.
Yeah. And the whole house came out of me. Anyway.
Yes.
So this bitch. Anyway, so I go to the colonoscopy. I wake up from it. And now my throat hurts. And
you attribute it to that.
Well, then they said, oh, well, we put oxygen up your nose. So I go home. Fine. I'm home. I start with the shivers, the shaking, the diarrhea, the headache, the nausea. The next morning I wake up, I'm 100 on the dot. I said, fuck me. They called me to ask how I was feeling. And I said, well, to be honest, the colonoscopy part, I think went fine. But, and then I told her and you can hear in her voice, like it was a disappointment. It was like, oh, like
and
I
happened.
Felt terrible. Like I definitely am somebody who respects
but
germs.
Tell what your husband did, which I
well, first love. He didn't believe me that this is the woman who got us sick because, you know, he doesn't want, he knows me and he knows now I'll never go back. I don't care if she's covered in a fucking bubble.
No.
I will never trust this woman.
No.
And I'm,
nor,
and,
no,
and
why
one
would
time
you?
I go out, I got sick.
Thank you. Why would you?
And not for nothing, but my life and is different.
Do
I
do
you
know
you
she
chemo.
Got all those other fucking people
she
sick?
She did. Everybody got sick. So she made a post on Facebook about something. My husband linked on and goes, thanks fuck getting everybody fucking sick.
Good.
She never responded.
No. Fucking bitch. Fuck you,
all
bitch.
All it takes is wearing a mask. I wore one yesterday. And yeah, people aren't wearing them a lot.
No.
Around here. And people look at me funny.
Yep.
People look at me. But I don't care. I have just got over being sick. I'm trying to protect other people.
You and me have a pact. I mean, this is the first time I've seen her in a week.
Yeah.
Because I was down for the count with the cumulative chemo.
Yep.
She's down with the count with the flu, but never got COVID, which mm-hmm. is good, which is good. But yeah.
Took 3 different tests. I was paranoid about the COVID.
I'm surprised I let you in today.
Well, I'm not.
Now, who's talking to you now? I heard the whole fucking table shook.
Well, Daryl Hall wants and John Oates want to sing.
No, they're fighting. You mean they want to sing?
On my Pandora, that's what's buzzing.
Oh, no, no, no.
I've been really into Kenny Loggins lately.
I love Kenny Loggins.
I do too.
He's so weird.
We saw him live. John Hall & Oates and Kenny Loggins opened for them.
Oh, my God.
Back at Jones Beach.
Oh, my God. Do you know that when he got married, I think for the second time, it was an all-nude wedding? He was nude.
Why do people do that?
When you're high, you can do anything.
I mean, do you really want to sit on a chair with your fucking ass juices fucking coming out of you?
Stop it.
That's your body leaks everything. Your body leaks from every orifice all fucking day long, okay? While you're sleeping and excuse me, women who have intercourse, right? If you let a man ejaculate in you, it's 3 to 4 days that that stays up in there and comes out. 3 to 4 fucking days. Okay, ladies, I mainly just say this because don't do that like a week before you go to gynecologist because they'll know everything. Oh, they'll fucking know it.
That's a cave of horrors.
Yeah, they'll be like, you're getting sexy time. I'm just helping out my
By
females.
The way, I saw a picture. Maybe I'll try to find it for Joel.
Joel will find it for you.
Donald Trump's security team carried 8 bags. They were shopping bags from McDonald's every day that he was in court in New York City. 8 shopping bags yeah. filled with McDonald's.
He loves McDonald's. And
that fucking
piece
of shit.
What's going on with his lawyer? He's spending an awful lot of time with Alina Habibi or whatever her name is.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Yeah, whatever the fuck her name is.
And no Melania Trump around lately.
Oh, no. I'm feeling more and more confident that this horse's ass, with the way the shit that's coming out of his mouth, that it's going
to about the magnets. Did you see what he said?
No.
Because they're talking about these magnets in these elevators. And I mean, I don't know a lot about magnets. I just know if you give me a cup of water and I pour it on it, the magnets don't work anymore. Why don't they think of that?
What? Why don't magnets work when you wet? That's not true.
I know that's not true. Of course that's not true. But he's gone on these rants. And then there's a video of Giuliani ripping him an asshole, which I think is fucking weird.
What?
Kosher. Who the fuck is he talking to? He's like, and you should be in prison. And you know why. And then they show clips of just Giuliani like sucking Trump's ass for the past fucking six, 7 years.
Did you see the video that they just made called God Made Trump?
Yes. OMG.
I give up. I give up. And this and the early and the welfare of the other time. And God made Trump.
Donald J. Trump.
Who the fuck are these people? Anyway, let's get off of this. Do you want to know how you know if you're a narcissist?
You had an interview with your therapist yesterday. What did he tell you about yourself?
Number one, how dare you? How dare you share that I had therapy yesterday.
It's Monday. Everybody
and how
knows
dare
you
give away the sex of my therapist?
Everybody knows you have sex with your therapist on Mondays.
Oh my God. Look at her. She's cracking herself up. It's not funny. It's not funny. I don't have sex with my therapist.
No, that's not right.
No.
People do that. Do you know people end up getting divorced?
Dr. Phil changed into his tennis clothes in front of his receptionist.
Is that Robin, who then he married?
I have no idea what their names are. Okay, do you want to go from number 1 to number 5? Or do you want to go from 5 to 4?
Well, is 1 the best or the worst?
One, this is how you find out if you're a narcissist.
Okay, let me hear it.
Number 1.
Got it.
They deny any wrongdoing.
Okay, I don't deny things that I did.
Ever
so,
wrong,
right.
No wrongdoing.
Okay.
And number 2, they use deflection to control the conversation. Pew, 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 okay. Pew, pew.
I know a few people just jumped on my list right here.
Yep. 3, they play the victim.
Mm-hmm. She a hoe.
4, they gaslight you.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Okay, we thinking people?
Mm-hmm.
And the last one, they attack you.
Mm-hmm.
They attack you.
Yeah. I know a couple of them. I know a couple of them. One, she know who she is. She gonna say she don't listen, but she does.
Now you sound like a redneck. Mm-hmm. She don't know.
She don't know.
She don't know who she don't
she
think
she
She
can call me a potato if she want to.
Mm. Mm-hmm. I have been kind of obsessed lately with pooping.
Like you're doing a lot of pooping?
No.
You're pooping out at parties?
Are you pooping out at parties?
You a party pooper.
Are you...
Anyway.
No. No, I'm suddenly I'm quite interested in the bodily functions of I want to get bidets. I want yeah, bidets.
The days are nice.
And I've been, I sent to you a couple of days ago. Apparently, we're wiping wrong.
Yeah.
No more vagina to the front or from
front
the,
to the back.
The vagina to the taint. None of that's wrong. You're supposed to be wiping sideways. This is what some doctor said, because the crinkles on your butthole. I'm sorry. This is just, it's not where I expected the show to go just right this second.
Every time I poop, I wash myself with
yes
with, in a bidet well, style.
See, I yeah. want a bidet. Here. Pooping is good for your brain.
Mm-hmm.
An analysis of studies involving about 110,000 adults found that constipated participants, defined as those who had a bowel movement once every 3 or 4 days.
Ow.
Ow. Ow. Exhibited notably worse cognition than those who have bowel movements every day. I can't.
It's hard to think when you got to poop.
Oh, hold on. Equivalent to at least 3 years of chronological cognitive aging. The constipated had a 73% increased risk of cognitive decline because they're not taking a dump. While those who pooped more than once a day had only 37% increased risk. That's me. Study author... Choran Ma says she was surprised at how strong the associations were.
Hmm?
Well, hello. If you're holding on, I told you that whole story about John Wayne.
Yeah.
That when he died, he had like something like 60 pounds of poop in him.
So I know I've probably mentioned this once before, but my older daughter, she had her colon removed, her large intestine.
Oh.
And it was 8 feet long and like 9 pounds, which is not normal.
No.
And if you have a very large, windy, and here's what I will say. Wait, no, this is serious. Listen, medically speaking to young girls, let me just say something. Stop. Serious. This is serious. You young girls, you wear your clothes very tight. You wear things that are too small for you and you're stuffing yourselves in. And that is part of why my daughter had the problem she had.
Interesting. I would have never, ever thought
yes,
that.
Yes. By doing that, you are causing your organs to move and stretch in ways they're not supposed to.
Get the fuck out.
Yes.
Well, think of what the Kardashian shit's doing.
Oh, I'm sure they're fucking miserable. They cannot feel. I know for a fact that that makes you not feel good. And any woman
really?
Who has ever squeezed. Have you ever squeezed into a pair of pants that you didn't have a right to wear? And
no.
Okay, well, women, we do this, right?
No.
We lay down on the bed.
No.
And we suck it in and then we stand up and we can't. It's like, oh my God. And at the end of the night, your stomach hurts. You take your pants off. You have a huge
ring line around.
And you're uncomfortable. It can make you nauseous to wear clothes like that. But we do these weird things because we think men will be happier with our weird organs. So I'm just saying, young girls, I really wish we would. I got chewed up over a video I made the other day on TikTok. Okay, made a video on TikTok talking about how for hundreds of years, us women have tried so hard to not be tits and ass, to not have to give blowjobs to make extra money, to not have to be strippers and hookers, unless you want to be those things, I suppose.
Correct.
And now here we are with OnlyFans pages, with people selling themselves. Women will do about anything for money these days. It's pretty obvious.
Well,
and I just feel bad, like... I feel
We've
sad.
We've discussed this ad nauseum
yes.
about how society
mm-hmm.
is truly bacchanal. It is absolutely debauchery.
Yeah.
It's like OnlyFans, Cardi B with her cooter.
I just don't understand this.
I don't get it.
I don't either. And you know what? It's just this girl comes on and she's go, you're a misogynist. You're not a girl's girl. You're not for women.
What's a girl's girl?
If a girl's girl means that I'm okay with you whoring around and tilting your fucking crown off, I'm sorry to say, every time I see a woman and her crown is a little tilted, I tell her because I'm not embarrassed.
No.
I'm not ashamed,
no.
nor am I threatened no. by a beautiful woman
no.
or a woman with a better crown. But if you're going to wear it, stand up and be straight. Like, I know we talk a lot of dirty stuff and whatever, but like some of this stuff is fucking disgusting.
Okay. You're really bringing the show down.
Yeah. Well, people brought me down this week. Right. Some Emily cunt.
Some Emily cunt.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then how about, let's talk about our YouTube.
God, oh.
Okay, let's talk about, what's his name? Demir?
Yes.
Hey, buddy. Hey.
Hey. Thanks for watching. And thank you for participating.
Thanks for your interaction.
For interaction with Aaron, because Aaron loves to interact with YouTube people who are in their basement sitting alone with their father and mother upstairs eating mayonnaise sandwiches.
Hey.
Hey everybody, it's your old pal Stucky here for another Stucky's annual pop-up swap meet. And have I got news for you. This year's event is going to be epic. Now, I'm well aware that last year's pop-up went a little overboard and the police were called in, but I've looked over every citation and complaint and have figured out a way to circumvent any of those problems again. Stucky ain't dumb. So here's how it's going down for this year's pop-up. First and foremost, every vendor and participant must sign an NDA, you know, a non-disclosure agreement. What pops up here ain't nobody else's business. If you're looking for a hooker, guy or gal, to tinkle on your feet, no problem. The pop-up has you covered. Swap away with whoever has something you want and go to town with each other. If you like to dress all in leather and wants to swap with someone who wants to rub and polish your card piece and can offer a dozen homemade chocolate chip cookies, let the rubbing commence. And lest you think everything is just about kinky and sexual desires, oh no. The pop-up will still serve our more conservative attendees. You will still find homemade jams, decorative decoupage, dried floral arrangements, and home-churned butter waiting to be swapped with neighbors with just as enticing products and services. So come one, come all, or just come. Who cares? It's all safe and legally covered when you attend the second annual Stucky's annual pop-up swap meet. If it pops up, we'll have someone who'll want to meet it.
Stucky. I love his swap meets. I never miss a swap meet there.
What scared me was I didn't realize that that was me for about 3 seconds.
Who the fuck else could it have been? You potato head.
I didn't. No, wait. We were talking about Dilrod. Dilmud?
Demir?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Demir. It's just you and me, my friend.
Yeah.
Mano y mano. Demir is a man, right?
I have no idea.
Okay. It's between you and me. Sentient being between sentient being. Alexander the Great. It's in the books.
Yeah.
Dilmud. What's his name?
Demir.
Demir?
Demir.
Like demure?
No, he's certainly not. This person's not demure. The demure.
Look, back in the Romans, back in the Greek, they didn't separate male and male, female and no. male. They did not label. It was fluid back then, and Alexander had many lovers, and one in particular of whom I saw in Ephesus in Turkey. He built a tomb to him.
Yeah.
And it's no big deal, Dilmud.
Yeah, so fucking what? Alexander the Great was greater than you thought, right. Maybe.
Julius Caesar had a boyfriend.
Did you know that a lot of Vikings Egyptians...
I'm not done talking to Dilmud.
I'm telling him too.
Back
in that time, the yes. women went out and fought and the men stayed home, raised the babies and each other, you know?
Well, they Allegedly. Raised anything that came up.
Yeah, they went to Stucky's for sure.
Hey, it's Stucky's.
Stucky's Egyptian pop-up.
Your pyramid is tops on our list.
Anyway, so Dermot. Dude, lighten up.
Yeah, calm down.
This is what I'd like to know. And truly, reply back. What proof do you have? you can say, hey, Dave. I'd say we're okay. You can call me Dave when my name is David. But what proof do I have? Well, I've read countless books. I've traveled the world. I've been fortunate enough. And I've seen these epitaphs. I've seen these places. And I've listened to the guides who say, it was all fluid back then.
Yeah.
But what proof do you have?
Yeah.
That he married Helen of Troy.
Prove me wrong.
Prove me wrong, Dermot.
I'm going to sit here and be demure about it.
Oh, demure. That's his name?
His name is Demure. Name is Demure. Okay.
I can't get... you say Demure. I say Brockett.
I say tomorrow.
I say Lockett. Lockett. Brockett. Flockett. Socket. Let's call the whole thing off.
Let's call whatever the fuck you're doing off.
Okay.
Okay.
I got to tell you.
Okay. It's your turn.
Do you remember? Talk. No, we got to get you to.
It's fucking snowing.
Oh my God, it is.
I tried. I went like this before.
No. I did. I saw it, but now I see it. It's even more.
Yeah.
Just to give you a weather update. We got 7 inches of snow up here.
We got 11.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Maybe then that's more than 7.
I would think, yes, that's more than 7.
Okay. So let's say, you mean to tell me we got 11 inches and no one told me?
You would have thought you'd know that you had 11 inches.
That I had 11 inches?
What kind of gay man are you? You think you'd know if you had 11 inches.
I'm a chemo gay man.
Okay.
Don't.
Everything comes down a few inches. Ooh. What the fuck?
My chair hit the leg. Anyway.
Any hoot.
I'm feeling very personal today with the camera.
Hello.
Totally forgot what I was going to say.
Thank God.
So we get 11 inches of snow.
Yeah.
Thank you for, normally I plow on my ATV. And I really, 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 I had all intentions. I had my snow outfit on, my one-piece ski outfit, my goggles, which are right behind me there, shining in the background. I put those goggles on, and I plow. I love to snow plow. And I couldn't fucking move that day.
Nope.
And I'll be damned, my husband and this one, they had consorted with each other.
Pow-wowed.
They pow-wowed. And Charlie came up and a new guy and plowed us.
Yeah.
And it was wonderful. Now, here's the oxymoron. Dermot.
Demure.
Deluge.
Duty head.
Duty head. Here's the weirdness. Last night, your son came up and visited.
Yes,
here.
He did.
Last night, it was 45 degrees. Okay.
Yeah, what's it now?
It's 45 degrees. Now it's going to be like 33.
29.
All right. Yeah. That's look at that. And midnight tonight. Now, and it's going to start raining in the afternoon. Midnight tonight, it's going to be 50 fucking degrees.
Yeah.
50 degrees.
So means tomorrow everything's going to be icy.
So now before everyone was freaking out, we're getting 11 inches of snow. Now, flood.
Pick one, people
is right.
Go get your milk. Shut up.
Yes. Jesus Christ, like you don't have Kind bars or something in your house that you can nibble on for 2 days?
No, my God, no. That all of a sudden is the time where people need 12 course meals, 67 pieces of fucking shrimp, 900 crab legs.
Yes, yes.
12 gallons of milk.
You're absolutely right.
Not me.
No, not me.
Either. I'm on my way after this to pick up stuff to make a vegetable lasagna. My mother's a vegetarian.
Wait a minute. I didn't know that.
Yes, she's a vegetarian.
For how long?
Years.
Really?
Yeah, on and off for a long time, and then now
she doesn't eat meat.
No, she does something to her blood pressure. Actually,
how can she stay married?
She gets sick from meat. It's weird.
How can she stay married if she doesn't?
Don't worry, she makes my dad meat. Don't you worry. Actually, that's the good thing about her. She still cooks all his meat stuff.
Oh, really?
Likes. Yeah, yeah.
See, that's nice.
Yeah, she doesn't hate it, just it doesn't like her. So, yes, I did see your eyes light up.
Ladies and gentlemen, look at
that. That was rude. No lasagna for you then. I was going to offer you a vegetable lasagna.
Welcome. Who said that? Here in the studio, I'm Dave, your host. Who said that? Welcomes. What's your name?
Margaret.
Well. You're a demonstrative girl, Margaret.
Yes, I am.
Well, where do you hail from?
Japan.
I'm
here for the holidays.
Okay, you're not originally Japanese.
Are you judging me?
Well, no, you're a white woman.
No.
Margaret.
No. Don't make me laugh. I got a cough, okay? I'm born and raised in Japan.
You were born and raised in Japan?
Yes.
Okay, Margaret. Okay. All right, Margaret. Who said the following? Good judgment comes from experience, and experience comes from making bad decisions.
Maya Angelou.
No. Why would you say that?
I don't know.
You know, a couple of contestants just continually say Maya Angelou on this show.
Do they? Well, one day they'll be right.
Mark Twain said it.
He's a fucking punk.
He's dead.
Yeah, well, he was a punk.
He wrote Tom.
He was a punk.
Margaret, you may live in Japan, but you're not from Japan.
Okay. Is it my turn? Is it my show now? Because I'll be better. Hello and welcome to Who the Fuck Said That? And who do we have here today?
Sylvester!
Sylvester!
Yeah,
are
Sylvester.
You named after Sylvester Stallone?
No, the cat!
Oh, I saw a tweety
tweet. I'm getting that bird!
Yeah. Oh, Tweety Bird.
Yeah, Tweety Bird. I love Tweety Bird. Yes,
darling. Did you find the traffic getting here was bad?
S-Y-L-M-E-S-T-E-R. Sylvester.
I don't think that's right. I think you spelled it. Do it again.
S-Y-L-V-E-S-T-E-R. Sylvester.
No, sweetheart. Is your mother with you?
Yes.
Okay, good.
She's dead.
Oh, and you brought her anyway.
I keep her in a little cup.
I see. You brought her anyway.
Yes.
That was something.
Sylvester, the cat.
Are you ready for Who the Fuck Said
yeah,
That?
Yeah, Who the Fuck Said
All right.
Who the Fuck Said That? Okay.
I believe we are here on the planet Earth to live, grow, and do what we can to make this world a better place for all people to enjoy freedom.
That conservation chick, Greta Gerwig.
No.
Ah!
No, that was Rosa Parks, honey.
Rosa Parks!
Yes.
You get the fuck out of my bus seat!
Okay, this is not that kind of...
Who the fuck
sir,
said
can
that?
Can somebody come
Sylvester,
and get this guy?
Sylvester!
Rosa Parks!
Sylvester,
oh my God!
Hey, welcome back to Who Said That?
Hi.
With your kid. Let me do the intro first, okay? Okay. With your host, Dave. How you doing, everybody? Who do we have here in the studio? A lovely young woman.
Lucy. Yes, hi.
Hi, Lucy.
Hi.
You're very rambunctious.
Yes, I'm so excited to be here.
Oh, are you good with quotes?
I'm terrible, but I'm here.
Okay.
I raised my hand and they picked my name.
That's great.
Yeah.
We've got to look at more how we get people on this show. All right, Lucy, you ready?
I'm ready. Thanks, Dave.
Okay, just you can call me the host. Lucy, who said true life is lived with tiny... I'm sorry. We're going to have to go back.
All right. Go ahead, Dave. I'll give you another try.
Thank you, Lucy. Sure. True life is lived when tiny changes occur. Who said that, Lucy? True life is lived when tiny changes occur and done. Take your time. Okay, what is the answer? You're taking a lot of
Bill
time.
Bill Clinton.
No. Leo Tolstoy.
Oh, I was wrong.
Yeah, you were wrong.
Well, you know, I said I'm not good at this.
I mean, Bill Clinton.
Oh, boy.
What's the matter, Lucy?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, you're thinking of those papers.
I am.
Tell you what, let's get out of this show.
All right.
And say goodbye. Lucy, would you like to say hi to anybody out there?
To my mom, my dad, Uncle Billy Joe, my aunts,
Jesus
and
Christ,
Margaret.
You're loud.
I have 17 siblings. Thanks to John
okay,
and
you.
Kim and Sarah
cut her mic. Shut the thank you, Jesus Christ. Listen, listen, folks. We'll be back next week for Who Said That with me, your greatest host, Dave. Thanks and bye. Nice cough. If I get sick, I swear to Jesus on high.
I'm not contagious anymore. Well, from what I'm told, this cough, I've already had a cough.
You cough constantly.
Well, I have a problem with my left lung. It's not.
I have a problem with my right lung.
But I've had this problem for a long time. And anyway, so I wheeze to begin with on my left side.
Wheezy.
It's annoying. It's annoying, I have to say. But anyway, I did hear that people who are getting over this flu have residual headaches and coughs for several months. Like, it's aggravating.
I should have put up a spit guard.
I swear, I was thinking a little piece of glass would have.
Yeah, the spit. Get out of my area. Wow. Okay, would you like to know what you should never, ever charge on a credit card?
Sex toys?
It's not on here.
Hotel rooms?
No.
What?
Well, of course you're going to put hotel rooms.
Well, not if you're cheating.
Oh.
Dildos, you know, hotels, hookers, you would think your wife would see that.
All right, we're going to go backwards. There's six of them. Never, ever, ever put on a credit card.
Okay.
Number six, coming in at number six, investments, which kind of makes stupid sense.
Yeah.
You're not going to put.
Look at that snow.
Oh, now it's really coming down nice.
Shit.
That is total Courier and Ives. That's really pretty. And to think about it, it's 32 now.
29
now. In 4 hours, it's going to be 42.
Let's hope I don't slide down your driveway. Go ahead.
Why, are you excited?
No. That driveway, I've slid down your driveway backwards once before.
Are you excited?
No.
You excited?
Maybe.
Does that make you excited? Slipping and sliding?
You got AAA?
I do.
Okay, then I'm fine.
I have AARP.
I'm happy then.
Number five.
Yeah.
Things you can't afford.
Okay. Like food.
No.
Gross drugstore.
No. Oh. No. Okay. Number four. College tuition.
Okay.
Because of the interest.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you interested in this at all?
Yeah.
Because you're just.
I'm listening.
Okay.
Yeah.
Never charge on a credit card. Number three, taxes. Because they're service fees.
Yeah.
That you can always renegotiate.
Paying more.
And yeah. Number two, which was kind of. Who in their right mind would put a down payment on a credit card?
I don't know.
Isn't that kind of stupid?
Unless it was a business purchase, yeah.
Yeah. And the first thing, number one, never, folks, put on a credit card. Medical bills. Medical bills.
Who made this list? I can't believe fucking hookers and dildos weren't the first on this list.
What are you talking about? That's a cash business. I'm not going to charge a hooker on my credit card. Cash, baby.
Because that would be stupid.
Yes.
Yeah, because then people would be like, oh, shit. You fucking called up 1-800-fuck-a-hunk?
No, travel dicks.
1-800-fuck-a-hunk showed up?
Who the fuck-a-hunk. I'd like that.
1-800-fuck-a-hunk.
1-800-fuck-a-hunk.
Listen, and I better buy that number before somebody else does.
Fuck-a-hunk?
Fuck-a-hunk. 1-800-fuck-a-hunk.
Oh.
I told you about the ship-a-dick.
Ship a dick
website. You can go on shipadick.com and ship a dick to people.
A dildo?
Yeah, and all different kinds of dicks.
Ship a dick.
Ship a dick.
No, I don't know.
You're getting one in the mail.
Thanks. Hey, justice has been served. Do you remember the Republican head of the party in Florida, Christian Ziegler?
Yes.
He and his wife, who started
the lesbian
Moms for Liberty.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, who slept with another
MILFs
woman.
MILFs for Liberty.
Yeah, MILFs for Liberty. And now the other woman that
is suing them, right? Raped her.
Yes, raped her. And he said he wouldn't leave. Boy, is it snowing.
Yeah, Jesus, I'm thinking to myself,
this is
shit.
Fucking, I'm leaving too. I'm leaving on a jet plane. I don't know when I'll be back again.
on a jet plane. I don't know when I'll
anyway,
be back. I wasn't done. When I'll be back again. Okay.
Oh, babe.
No,
I
we're done.
I hate to go.
We're done. I said we're done.
Well, my bags are packed.
Ready to go.
I'm standing here outside, you ho. You didn't put out this morning, and so I'm pissed. So I'm leaving on a jet plane. You don't give me a puss, then I'll be back again.
Oh, thank God.
Oh, come on. This is going too fast. Getting too fast. Erin and her puss. Puss. Oh, yeah, I'm nothing. I've got nothing.
Thank God.
Slam the door.
How come guys get man caves? Do they ever think about us ladies? Women need a place to go sometimes, too. One that isn't sloppy and covered with their shit all over the place. You know, empty beer cans pushed all over the floor, 50 empty potato chip bags, and 20 cans of cheese whizzed, all whizzed out. Jesus Christ! I'm not even Catholic! Man caves isn't even the right word for what we gals would like to run into when our overbearing and chauvinistic husbands pull their shit. Fuck no! We need space. We need size. We need bitchhoods. Yeah, our bitchhoods come equipped with no televisions, no blaring fucking music, and definitely no forms of communication with the outside world. That means no kids, husbands, pets, or beings with a sentient mind. I'm talking leave me the fuck alone. Each hood comes with a 6x6 bubbling jacuzzi so you can float your naked ass, arms outstretched and legs apart with absolutely no fear of interlopers. Fully equipped bar with an incredibly good-looking foreigner who can't speak the language but can serve up the ultimate mojito and back rub. Can you hear me, ladies? You get naked, float, drink, and play with the scenery. Oh, yeah. Bitchhoods, don't fuck with us with your man caves, you dill hole.
Wow.
I forgot about that one.
I did too. That was a little...
That was extra. She's bitchy.
It fits with today's mood. She totally fits with today's mood.
I agree.
I generally don't like to do this with you and I, that, you know, this is our podcast.
Yeah.
It's David and Erin. We all know Joel is the producer. I just realized we asked Joel to do something, and I'm realizing right now.
He didn't do it.
He didn't do it.
I know what it is, too. It has to do with one of these buttons, baby.
Yes.
Yeah, Joel.
Yeah, Joel.
Mm-hmm.
We were going to have a button for the Say What game
show.
Say
what?
Say what?
Oh, my God. Nothing came out. Say what?
No, nothing but germs. Smoke your joint.
Okay.
Jesus Christ. I got to get you in an altered state. Since that commercial, the snowfall is now coming down. It's like a fucking blizzard.
I had to put my emergency brake on in your parking, in your driveway.
Oh, Sam slid down last night. He stopped the car. It was hysterical. He was where you were. He stopped the car and his face is looking at me at the window.
Oh.
And the car went backwards and then stopped.
Oh, geez.
Yeah. I backed him out, though, last night.
How was the car?
The car, I've never seen a filthier car in my fucking life. And he looks and I said, are you shitting me? Are you shitting me? I'm 17. I said, dude, there was so much shit and garbage.
When he went to Disney for that week and I had the truck back and I opened
it. Don't say you cleaned it.
I did. Oh, I opened the door and I was like, don't do it. Don't do it. And I opened it and I was like, what the fuck?
It was the filthiest. I'm sorry, Sam, for ratting you out, dude.
That's all right. He knows it.
But I got in and it was like, what? What? I get crazy when I have my lunch and a French fry falls over.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I mean, you and I are just so fastidious with our cleanliness. Anyway, so see, you're deflecting for Joel. You're deflecting.
I'm actually thinking to myself, I'm looking at the snow and I'm thinking, is my mother's plane going to land in Jersey?
Oh my God. Yeah. This is nothing. This is gone in 2 hours. It stops snowing.
She lands at 3:45. You know what I'm saying?
Then it'll be raining.
All right.
Oh, trust me. This is nothing.
Now, I'm really glad my brother offered to pick her up and bring her back to the airport.
Oh, there's a stable person. Uh-oh. That's going to be okay. Let's just move on, shall we?
It's like somebody turned a faucet on out there.
Well,
I love it.
I know. It is quite
pretty.
Anyway,
let's get back to what we're supposed to be doing.
Well, here, let's press this button. Say what?
Say what? Wait, let's find one. Let's just, wait, hold on. I'm going to do a random pick.
Okay, just do it.
Wherever this stops, nobody knows.
Toto, I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore. Say what? That works.
Okay.
Okay, you ready?
I'm ready. Say what?
Say what? Grr.
Runt.
Okay. Tur.
Tull.
Sp.
Getty.
You are so queer. Blah.
Under.
Me.
Schiff.
Kl. Jesus. You couldn't have come up culinary.
Christ.
Clue.
You said Jesus.
I said clue.
And I said ooh.
And you said ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh. Cle. Oh, you know what? You're a pig. Okay, thank you. And duh.
Runk.
What?
Drunk.
Duh. Runk?
Duh. Jarunk.
Don't runk? Drunk?
Dribble.
You suck. You know what? You do have foggy brain. You do have foggy brain.
Want to try them again?
You want me?
Yeah, you ready?
You're going to do me?
Mm-hmm. Say what?
Wait. Let me do, Matt. Now, let me do.
Hi-ho.
Hi-ho. Say what?
Welcome to Say What the Fuck. Ready?
Yes, I'm
okay.
Okay.
Mothra. What?
Mothra.
Okay, all right, okay. I accept that. I accept that. You ready?
You. Yes.
Great. I was thinking gorilla, but okay.
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 Ready?
Yes.
Majesty. That wasn't bad.
Thank you.
Th.
You.
What?
Let's do it again.
Th.
F.
Th. Th, T-H, th.
Teague.
Fatigue?
Fatigue.
I said th, T-H.
You're not enunciating correctly.
Th.
All right, thud.
Ready? I got one more.
Okay.
La.
F.
I was thinking mp, lamp, but okay.
That was good.
Good job.
And Joel, thank you so much for having that new...
Yes, that new say what?
Hi-ho!
Hi-ho!
I'm going to have to fucking clean that. I'm going to send it to the dry cleaner. I got to go to the dry cleaner today. Oh my God. I got to give a shout out.
Who are we giving a shout out to?
My favorite sushi place in Monticello, New York. You're the one with the bearer of bad news.
I was.
They're closing.
What's the name?
Soy.
Yeah.
And my buddy Alan, who's there, we're keeping in touch. It's so funny because it comes in Chinese. And then it's translated because it's Asian, it's fusion, Asian and Japanese. And they're closing. We've gone there over 10 years.
Yeah.
Over 10 years we've gone. And COVID did it.
Yeah. A lot of places and they lost a lot of their cooks and the food's just not the same. The product isn't the same.
No.
Every time we eat out, I get sick lately.
No. Well, we haven't eaten out.
Yeah. No, I mean, even bringing in food,
if something
isn't right.
Girl, I hear what you're saying. I hear what you're saying.
I'm not going to stop doing it, of course.
Well, no. Otherwise, all right. Listen,
you have anything else? Or are you done here? Because we're done here.
No, we don't. Let me just do this.
Okay.
Do we have time?
Yes.
Okay.
For one of your shenanigans, guys.
This is just society in general, which I thought was fucking fabulously interesting.
Okay.
70% of Americans want marijuana legalized.
Okay.
70%. 52% of Americans own a gun.
Okay.
52%. That's a lot. That's a lot. 71. Oh, who is this for? Dilbert? Dilwood? Durham?
Demi?
Demi Moore? 71% of Americans believe in same-sex marriage.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to know, Dilmud, if you're, I mean, you said you lived in the basement of your father's
home. No, I said that.
Oh, I thought you did.
No, I said that, I'm sitting here waiting for you to respond to me from your dad's basement while you're eating popcorn.
Oops. Sorry, Delwood. 60% of Americans rate their financial situation as good or excellent.
They're liars.
60%.
Fucking liars.
Okay. That was it. I just...
Thank you for bringing everybody down, Debbie David.
What about Darren?
Demi Moore. No, she's okay.
No, she's not. She's in that whole body thing. Look at me.
Did you see Lisa Rinna fucking pose nude? Girlfriend, first of all, what the fuck happened to your face? I want to honestly say it looks like somebody came up behind you and just blew a lot of air into the back of you and your face just popped up.
Do you know what I noticed?
What?
I saw that picture.
Right, with her lips.
I mean, she has chipmunk cheeks to begin with, but now... Yeah, the lips.
That was one lip.
The lips. Isn't she still married to Harry Hamlin?
I don't know.
Oh, my God. You looked like a mule.
This is what started me with that whole video.
I saw clips of the New Year's Eve on. I don't know if it's ABC. It's ABC.
At Mar-a-Lago?
At Anderson Stewart. Anderson Stewart.
Andrew Stewart, and he's on.
Anderson Cooper.
Uh-huh.
And I'm not crazy about Andy Cohen. Girl, Andy Cohen's face was so Botoxed. There wasn't a crinkle. There's Anderson with a regular face. He had a regular face, you know. Cohen's face was just like, what the fuck?
Like somebody went behind him and...
Yes!
It's weird.
It was just... And I'm thinking, dude.
And everybody knows that you've had work done. You guys are right. Famous fucking people. We look at a picture from you from 20 years ago and now.
Yeah. But you know what? You're absolutely right. I'm looking at Anderson going, there's Anderson Cooper. And then that went to Andy and I went, oh my God.
Like, right?
What the fuck did you do to your face?
I cannot wait to see the movement of people who stop doing this. That is going to be when women and men can really just shine on whoever they're supposed to be and not trying this fake Botox bullshit.
Bitches.
You can call me a granny all you want. I'll take
granny.
I am a fucking granny.
You
so fucking
wrinkled ass prune.
Oh, so are you.
You fucking apple rind that's been set out in the sun for 45 days and is now brown, rancid, and putrid. Goodbye.
Calm the fuck down.
Calm the fuck down.
With David and Aaron.
With David and Aaron.